In this series, I look at different heroes, items, and strategies you can use against an ultimate ability in Dota. And from this comment, I'm going to be looking at Chronosphere. First off, we have to look into the mind of a Faceless Void player, and it's really important to know and remember what lane Faceless Void has been played in. If he's played in the safe lane, he's going to be able to kill you at level 6, so he has a lot of damage, and he will also have supports nearby to help secure these kills. Whereas an offlane Faceless Void will probably be more focusing around initiation and having strong team fights and potentially looking for rotations. If the rotations don't happen, then Faceless Void Chrono is not going to be used, and he might only use it defensively. Typically, you don't want to be using it defensively just because of the really long cooldown. Whereas when you can play it aggressively, every time it's off cooldown, you can turn that into a kill. And it combines really well with a lot of spells such as Sunstrike, Skyrat Mage's spells, Witch Doctor's Ultimate. There's a bunch of other spells that work really well with Chronosphere, and a lot of the time it will insta-kill any hero in the game. Now this is incredibly powerful, and you really need to know how you can counter this. One of the strongest things later in the game with dealing with Chronosphere is saving for buyback, especially with the fact that in a late game teamfight, Chronosphere is just going to instantly kill one hero in the game. It's very, very hard to deal with, and you can't always rely on your teammates. So having all heroes on your team saving for buyback will be really effective, because you don't really know who Void is going to jump on, especially when you have this offlane Faceless Void where sometimes they'll build Aghanim Scepter and you'll have a really low cooldown, so you can't exploit this long period cooldown. Faceless Void is pretty bad at fighting outside of his chrono later in the game, especially if he has to use his BKB or if he has to use his BKB while during his chrono. These are all things where showcase that you can exploit his cooldowns. Anytime that he messes up an ultimate, you have to go and push objectives, you have to force a fight somewhere and make it difficult for the enemy team at that point, because they want to fight around this long period cooldown. So what ways does Void actually initiate? Well, one is just time walking in. He can buy a Shadow Blade, which I see quite commonly, and you also have a Blink Dagger. Plus, there's also the other option of getting plus 500 time walk range talent. So these are all things that you can see sometimes coming. If you place sentries down where you think Void is going to walk, you can silence or stun him before he gets his ultimate off, or blink away or something like that. If you see him time walking onto you, or you can see a ward before he blinks onto you, you have vision of him before he is essentially initiating on you, you can use your Ghost Scepter or some other item, or you can essentially, it's important to anticipate what he's trying to do, because you could just die from full health. So what kind of heroes should we be picking against Faceless Void? Well, there's a number of options out there. One of the best ones, if you're laning against him, is to pick Doom, because not only have you a lot of passive regen, you can also get a lot of armor. You have a lot of health later in the game, but the fact that Doom can shut down Void, and it can essentially make it very hard for him to lane once Doom hits level 6. But just picking a bunch of durable heroes is not always the best case against Faceless Void, because you could just get all chronoed, especially if you have a lot of melee heroes. You end up standing close together, and it makes it easier to get a multi-hero chrono. One of the most impactful ways of dealing with chrono is picking a save hero. Now there's a bunch of these out there, and I'm going to go through a list of them. The two best save heroes against Chrono are Shadow Demon and Winter Wyvern. Straight up, just because you can save your ally from taking damage. Shadow Demon is probably a little bit better, because if Faceless Void is Chrono Summon and then they use magical spells such as Sunstrike or Skyrat Mage's Ultimate down on top of it, then you're not blocking that magical damage with Winter Wyvern's heal. Now the thing is, Winter Wyvern can use Winter's Curse on Faceless Void, and it will disable him for most of, if not all of, the duration of Chrono. Now one thing that's really important to take into consideration is Faceless Void's other talent, which is to increase the AoE of Chronosphere. Now this is really important, because if Faceless Void uses his Chrono and he puts the enemy hero right in the middle of Chrono, like in the middle of the AoE, Shadow Demon won't actually have enough range to use disruption on your ally. So a lot of the time, if you are picking something like Shadow Demon, you want to pick up an Aether Lens just for that extra cast range. This can same apply for almost any other hero, having these longer cast range spells just to make it difficult for Void in his chrono and forcing him to use a BKB. One of the other top tiered safe heroes is Outworld Devourer, and you don't have to play a support. Now, other options that you have that can also save are stuff like Pugnaz Heal. You have a little potential there with Omni Knight, his cast range isn't that good. And one of the better heroes that's very good as well at closing down a team fight or like stalling it is Naga Siren, just because of her song, it makes it very difficult. And you also have the potential to kill Faceless Void and lock him down with your net, and it forces him to build a Manta style. The idea of the Naga Siren support is very impactful, and it's really important to get those songs off at the right time, because otherwise it kind of makes that pick a little bit useless. The other hero that's there as well that you have is using Witch Doctor's ultimate against Chrono. So you use your ultimate afterwards and forces Void to move back, and he can't actually play aggressive within his Chronosphere if you put down your Debt Ward in the right place. And even BKB won't prevent the damage from Witch Doctor because it's physical damage. And as you can see, that these heroes are ones that act outside of the chrono, and that they kind of disrupt the whole team fight and make it difficult for Void. They're long range spells, essentially. And any other spell like Nimbus from Zeus is really good. And a bunch of other heroes, even like using Windranger, Shackle Shot, or her Power Shot. There's a bunch of spells, and Mirana's Arrow, anything that you can use that just goes into the chrono. Fissure is very good, Kunkka's Torrent, his Ghost Ship, anything that really helps save your allies. And you can potentially, in the really late game scenarios, you can buy an E-Blade and E-Blade your ally or yourself, whichever Void hits in the chrono. You could just really keep going on with a massive list of all these spells that you could use. It's just essentially just try and keep making Faceless Void use his BKB for every single kill. Stick together, teamwork going to be very impactful against Chronosphere throughout the game, especially once he reaches a point where he has a lot of items. But if possible, try and pick heroes that are not super squishy. So it might mean that, hey, I'm going to pick Ogre Magi, it's going to be difficult for Void to get off a kill on me. Whereas if you pick something like Mirana or Lion, you don't have a lot of base health, and you may even need to get a little bit more health. You might just die really easily. Similar to stuff with Crystal Maiden as well. And Void will a lot of the time react if you pick a hero like Crystal Maiden, and the Root, he'll buy a Manta. And similar stuff will happen against Skyrat Mage, and you can just dispel these very easily, so you don't really do much against him in a team fight either. Now, going on to the last topic, which is items. What should you be buying against Faceless Void? Well, it depends if you're a core or support. One of the things, if you're an offlane or even a support, is to pick up something like a Solar Crest, because you can put that on your ally and essentially save them if you're not the one getting chronoed. You can buy a Yule's, which is really good as well. However, buying something like a Glimmer Cape may or may not work. The problem is that you will reduce the amount of magical damage they're taking, but they're not taking any reduction from the physical damage, and Void has True Sight within his Chronosphere. So sometimes as well, if you're playing a support, you might want to go down the route of buying items that give you more HP, like Aghanim Scepter or something even like a Rod of Atos, which can be difficult for Void to deal with, forcing him to use his Manta or even build Manta, force his BKB. You need to make it difficult for Void not to just go this glass cannon build. The other things are stuff like defensive items that make you more durable. Not so much stuff like Lincoln's Fear, but what I'm talking about is getting something like Evasion with Halberd, or just getting, again, more HP items. You want to not necessarily build a Skadi or a Heart, but you want to be buying stuff maybe like a pipe for your allies. You can use it outside. It depends on what the enemy's lineup is doing and what type of damage that you're taking. Greaves can sometimes be good if you don't get caught within the Chronosphere, and it can give your allies more armor going into it. So if you think Void is going to initiate and your teammates are low, you can give them more armor. That's one of the things that people forget about a lot of the time. Then if you get into the super late game, you hit these like 60 minute games, a must have item against Faceless Void is an Aeon Disc. If you don't have that, you're just going to get obliterated. The only other option is like, again, like on heroes like say Centaur or Underlord, it can be very useful to buy maybe something like a heart, because it's going to be very difficult to burst you down from full health. The one last thing I want to mention is a tip for Faceless Void players. If your allies don't have very long cast range or they're mostly melee heroes, try and catch the enemy at the edge of your Chronosphere. If you can do that, then your allies can hit on melee range at the enemy within the Chronosphere. Whereas if you hit them at the middle of the Chronosphere, it can be very difficult just to get spells off or just do that physical damage of auto attacks. Now there's a bug going around on YouTube, so if you're already subscribed, the videos might not get shared out to you. So it's really important to hit that notification button. If you're not already subscribed, go do that. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you in the next.